Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons, and today's problem is going to be to find the mode of inheritance. Looking at this pedigree, and mode of the inheritance can be whether this is autosomal recessive genetic disorder, autosomal dominant genetic disorder, X-linked recessive genetic disorder, X-linked dominant genetic disorder, Y-chromosome linked, or it also can be mitochondrial linked genetic disorder. And on the first glance, it looks like this is autosomal recessive genetic disorder. For example, genotype of this parent can be capital A small a, genotype of this parent also can be capital A small a, so both would be heterozygous, both would be carriers, and this child would be homozygous recessive, and the rest of the children of this family can be whether heterozygous or can be homozygous dominant. So, for example, if one parent would be heterozygous, another parent also would be heterozygous. If it is autosomal recessive genetic disorder, then in the progeny, we may expect the following genotypes and phenotypes. Capital A here. Capital A, small a here, capital A, small a here, and small a here. And as you see, three quarters of the children in this family going to have normal phenotype. Both parents also would have normal phenotype, and we also can expect that one quarter in such a family would be affected. And this is what we see here. But this is only on the first glance. If we would take a close look at what happens in the following generation, so we have generation 1 here, so Roman numbers would show us generations, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 generations we have here, and usually we put people in each generation in the order of their age. So the oldest would be on the left side and the youngest would be on the right side. Now let's take a look what happens in each generation, and we would find interesting pattern. In this family only boy is affected, and this family also has a female child which is married to unrelated person. And once again, in this family, this female is unaffected, but her sons, some of her sons are unaffected, but some are affected. What we see in this family, we see that none of the people would be affected here. And in this family, we see that none of the children is affected, but in the next generation, we see affected male. And the same is true is here. So we see that this genetic disorder skip generations. So it is not present in this generation, but present in following generation. And if we see one affected affected person in this generation, in the following generation, we do not see any affected people. But in the next generation, once again, we see affected person. The same is true here. Nobody is affected here, but we see affected person here. But here we do not see skipped generation, and I will explain why. But general pattern that we see that this trait can skip generations, and we see that only males are affected. We do not see affected females here. And this gives us information that this is X-linked genetic disorder. And we can say that this is X-linked recessive genetic disorder. So this is genotype of this female, defective X chromosome and normal X chromosome. And male genotype would be normal X and normal Y chromosome. Now let's build a Punnett square for this couple. So genotype of the male here on the top, and genotype of the female here on the side. And now we can see what is going to happen to the progeny. So defective X chromosome from the mother side and normal X chromosome from the father side, defective X chromosome from the mother side and normal Y chromosome from the father side, normal X chromosome from the mother side, normal X chromosome from the father side, and normal X chromosome from the mother side, normal Y chromosome from the father side. And as you see, 50% of the male progeny would be affected, because this is X-linked recessive genetic disorder. Phenotype of the mother would be normal, because mother has another X chromosome with dominant allele, and dominant allele is normal. And father also has normal phenotype, and as you see, all of the daughters also would have normal phenotype. Those 50% of the daughters would be carriers, and 50% of the male progeny would be phenotypically normal. Now let's explain what happens in this family in the next generation. This male is affected, so he have to get defective X chromosome from his mother. So his genotype would be defective X chromosome and normal Y chromosome that he got from his father. And as for the genotype of this female, we are not sure. This can be normal X chromosome from father side, because father only can give normal X chromosome. But mother can give whether defective or also normal X chromosome. Anyway, no matter what chromosome this female will get, her phenotype would be normal. So we can say that her phenotype is normal X chromosome and blank space. Because this is X-linked recessive genetic disorder. And what we can tell about this female? Because this female has two affected sons, we can say that one of the X chromosomes have to be defective, that she got from her mother side. So this is have to be her genotype. And from the father, she only can get normal X chromosome. So father have only normal X chromosome with dominant allele. So phenotypically, this female would be normal. But once again, when we know that her genotype is defective X chromosome and normal X chromosome, this female, even if her husband is phenotypically normal, still 50% of the male progeny would be affected. So genotype of this male is defective X chromosome, normal Y chromosome, and defective X chromosome and normal Y chromosome. And male that is phenotypically normal have to get from mother side normal X chromosome and normal Y chromosome from the father side. And as for the genotype of this female, we can be sure, we know for sure that she got normal X chromosome from the father side, because father only can give normal X chromosome. But from mother side, this female can get with the defective X chromosome or normal X chromosome, still her phenotype would be normal. So we can say that her genotype is normal X chromosome, and for the second we just leave a blank space. Now let's take a look what happens here, and let's analyze first this couple. We know that father has defective X chromosome, and if father would have defective X chromosome, 100% of his daughters would be phenotypically normal, but would be carriers. 100% of the daughters would be carriers, and none of the male children would be affected, because male children do not get X chromosome from their father, only can get Y chromosome. So we can say that genotype of this female have to be heterozygous, defective X chromosome, and normal X chromosome that she got from her mother. Her mother also can be a carrier. She can get this defective X chromosome from her grandmother through her mother's side. But because we know that this female is unaffected, that means that she got normal X chromosome from her mother's side. So genotype of her mother have to be a normal X chromosome and blank space. And as for this male is genetically unrelated to this family. So we call this outcrosser, and we have to assume that his genotype is normal. If he would have defective X chromosome, he would be affected. So his genotype is normal X and normal Y chromosome. And once again, in such a family, 50% of the male children would be affected. So we see that this male got defective X chromosome from the mother's side, normal Y chromosome from the father's side, and we also can for sure say that this male got normal X chromosome from the mother's side and normal Y chromosome from the father's side. But we cannot be so sure about this female. We know that this female got normal X chromosome from her father's side, but she can get whether defective X chromosome from the mother or normal X chromosome from her mother. Still, her phenotype would be normal, so blank space here. Now let's take a look at this side of the pedigree, because something interesting here. We have affected male, and also one of the males in this family we see also affected. And we know that if father has defective X chromosome, none of his sons can be affected, because sons would get only Y chromosome from the father's side and X chromosome from the mother's side. And this gives us information that genotype of this male is defective X chromosome and normal Y chromosome, and genotype of this female have to be defective X chromosome and normal X chromosome. So this female is unrelated to this family, is not descendant of these two people, but she also carries this genetic disorder, and that explains why male who is affected, who is father of this child, also would have male progeny that is going to be affected. So this male got his defective X chromosome not from the father's side, but from mother side. And from the father side, because he is a male, he got normal Y chromosome. Now let's take a look at the genotypes, for example, of this male. This male only can get from the father side normal Y chromosome, and because genotype of this male is normal, we know that he got normal X chromosome from his mother. And the same we can say about this male. And as for the female here, we can say that from father's side, this female got defective X chromosome, and from mother's side, she can get with a defective X chromosome, and in this case she would be affected, or she can get normal X chromosome. And as you know, this female is phenotypically normal, so we know that she's obligate carrier. But once again, in this family, in this couple, not only male children can be affected, but female children also can be affected, because both parents have this defective X chromosome. And of course we can say that this male got his defective X chromosome from his mother. So mother have to be a carrier, and this female also got this defective X chromosome from her mother. So her mother also have to be a carrier. And we also can put genotypes of all people who is going to be outcrossers. So we just have left few people without genotypes shown, so we can put genotype for this person to normal X and normal Y chromosome here, and this male has defective X and normal Y chromosome, this person has normal X and Y chromosomes, and a female here have to have one normal X chromosome that she got from her father's side, and the second chromosome can be with a normal or can be with defective gene on it. So normal X chromosome and blank space, and looks like we gave genotypes to every person in this pedigree. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. Share this video with your classmates, and see you in the next video. Goodbye.